Ramadan.
إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونؤمن به ونتوكل عليه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ونشهد أن سيدنا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله أما بعد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. All praise is due to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we have now reached the 20th fast of this holy month of Ramadan. And we are now entering into the last 10 days, the most important of the 10 days. And if you want to know how valuable this 10 days is, the most valuable month in the whole year is the month of Ramadan. And the most valuable part of the month of Ramadan is the last 10 days. And the most valuable night out of the last 10 days is the night of Laylatul Qadr, or the night of Qadr, the night of decree. Now, inshallah, in the next 10 days, our plan is to find this night. What is this night? We're not going to go into this too much, but in general, let's just look at the Quran. It says, "Inna anzalnahu fi laylatil qadr." That indeed we have revealed it in the night of Qadr, meaning we reveal the Quran Sharif on the night of Qadr. So as the Mufassirun, they commentate and they say that it could either mean that the first revelation came down to this earth was on the night of Qadr, or it could mean that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the Quran from himself to Lawh-e-Mahfuz on the night of Qadr. So whatever the interpretation is, we know that the most powerful, what makes this night so powerful is the revelation of the Quran. So how better to spend the night of Qadr, to spend these blessed nights that are coming up, except by reading Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala continues to tell us that this night is better than 1,000 months. And if somebody wants to do the maths, they can check. But we already see that there was this, there's a little tale that comes with this understanding of 1,000 months. That, and I don't know the authenticity of this, but it really captures what is the essence of this night. And it is that a woman at the time of Bani Israel complained to one of the prophets and said that, "O prophet, tell us about the end times." So the prophet said that there will be a prophet, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will come, who is the last of all the prophets, right? And his people will live 60 to 63 years. This woman started laughing. And she said, how can they live 60 to 63 years? What are they going to acquire in such a short amount of time? What are they going to acquire in such a short amount of time? Now, the Prophet alayhi salam, he replied by saying that these people will have such a night in there which is more valuable than all the years that you live. So because these people of Banu Israel, they used to live hundreds of years, mashallah. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us this short amount of time, but with very, very powerful nights. And these nights are the nights of Qadr, the nights of decree. Now Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not specified through Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam which night it may be. Now obviously the ulama, they comment that various nights have different virtues. But we should remember that we should be searching for the night every odd night. So we know it is confirmed it's one of the odd nights. So it could be either the 21st night, which is after Maghrib tonight, or it could be the 23rd, the 25th, 27th, and the 29th night. Now, what does it mean for a person to search for Laylatul Qadr? What does it mean to search for Laylatul Qadr? It means that we become such people that we please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to such an extent that He forgives all our sins. That's what we want to attain. That's what we want to attain by using Laylatul Qadr. Now, normally we start to become quite overwhelmed. Such a powerful night. How am I going to spend it, right? And sometimes we might become such that we give it all we can on the first night, and then we start to become lazier. Hatta when it comes to the 29th night, which is a possibility that it may be Laylatul Qadr. But what do we end up saying? What do we end up doing? We start to mess around, or we start to become lazy. So we have to be such that we need to treat all the nights properly. We have to use our efficiency skills so that we can make the most out of Laylatul Qadr. So the first piece of advice that I want to give here will be that make yourself physically able to make the most out of Laylatul Qadr, which means that you might have to fix your sleeping pattern. You might have to take a few days off the mundane work that you do. You might have to reduce the intake of your food. Now, it depends on each person. For them, they know how they function the best. Now, you know, for some people, a diet is good. For some people, it's not when it comes to functioning the best. So we have to know that we need to be able to function the best we can. Once we've sorted out how we are going to function, now if that means to eat less at iftar, to make sure that we are ready, get enough sleep so that we can recite the Quran, to put away our distractions, to maybe put the phone away for a few hours every day at least, to cut ourselves off from our friends just for 9-10 days. And you know, mashallah, for the last few months we have been in quarantine where we had to stay home much more than usual, and we have already accustomed our souls and our body to staying home. So if we've already done that, why don't we just top it up? Why don't we just beat everything now and just let go of everything and look for our Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, His forgiveness and His mercy in the last 10 nights of Ramadan. Now I want to share with you inshallah the most effective way of spending the last 10 nights, which takes into consideration people when they are not able to use their time efficiently when it comes to worshipping. So we all know that we are not perfect, and we are the sinning slaves of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We all are, and we have to admit that. If we deny that, then we have a sort of arrogance that cannot be changed or that cannot be rectified. So first thing is, we know that we are sinning servants, and we also know that we are lazy. We are lazy. So once we know that, now I am going to fix my night according to my laziness and my sins. So what I will do, and what the best way of spending the night is, to have 3 slots within the night. Now you can have 1 slot, for example, just before Isha. You can have a slot after Isha, and you can have a slot at the time of Sehri. Now what do I do in these slots? Each slot should be 20 minutes long. Only how long? 20 minutes, right? Now you might think, what am I going to do in 20 minutes? The thing is, it's about quality worship. It's not about quantity. It's not about sitting there and just getting everything done. No, it's about quality in 20 minutes. Now remember, there's some studies that shows that a human brain or a human body is most active for only 20 minutes. And that's why we see sometimes when we advise student to only take a lesson for 20 minutes and then use the other 20 minutes to recap or to relive what they learned. So this is why 20 minutes. What are we going to do in that 20 minutes? The first 5 minutes, we're going to pray 2 rak'at of salah. Now, if we don't know a lot of surahs from the Quran, then we should make our sujood and our ruku extra long, right? So, but we should spend around 5 to 6 minutes praying 2 rak'at of salah. Then after that, we should sit down for 5 minutes and pray, read the Quran Sharif. And if that means to read one side, if that means to read half a side, half a page, one little surah, whatever we can in those 5 minutes. Now, if we cannot learn, if we do not know how to read the Quran, inshallah, make intention that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives you the tawfiq to learn how to recite the Quran. Secondly, just stare at the Quran. Imam An-Nawawi rahimahullah, he says that there is a reward for the person who gazes at the Quran. So we know that just by staring at the Quran, at least I will receive a reward. And stare at it with the intention, oh Allah, I promise you, I will learn how to recite this Quran, and I promise you, I will listen and I will obey what is in this Quran, inshallah. And once you make that promise and you stare at the Quran, only for 5 minutes. After that, you make 5 minutes of dhikr and istighfar. And that means to say, and the easiest is to do subhanallah 100 times, alhamdulillah 100 times, Allahu Akbar 100 times, astaghfirullah 100 times, and durood upon the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam 100 times. Simplest is sallallahu alayhi wasallam. So you can see that each dhikr only takes a minute. So you've spent another 5 minutes doing the dhikr of Allah and istighfar and durood. After that, you move on to 5 minutes of dua. For those 5 minutes, you get your heart into a weeping mode and you start to ask Allah, and imagine to yourself that I have to ask for everything I can because Allah is in the giving mode. It's almost like you're picking up. Imagine somebody chucked so much wealth on the floor and you're just picking up as much as you can, but you only have 5 minutes. Do dua in this manner and your concentration level will be so high bi-idhnillah subhanahu wa ta'ala. After you've done your dua, now another tip for dua is try to make a list of all your dua du'as today, that all the du'as that you're trying to come and fulfill just from today. So what that would do, inshallah, it will make you more concentrated on your du'a. You know what you want to accomplish. Now once that 5 minutes is over, then you can take a break, inshallah. And while you're taking a break, then the main thing is, don't speak unnecessarily and do not commit any sins. Right? Don't speak unnecessarily and do not commit any sins, and wait for your next 20-minute slot. Now for some people, you can do this slot 5 times, 6 times, 7 times. And for some people, even if you do it twice or 3 times, it is still a good way to really spend spend the Laylatul Qadr the way it deserves to be spent. Now obviously, illa mashallah, some of you guys, inshallah, you have the taqat, you have the actual quwwah, the capability to really go extra far, extra mile. And if you can do that, inshallah, may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for you, and you should definitely do that. We shouldn't limit to this method, but this method, you could say, is the bare minimum. This is the method that my teachers, they used to advise us, and alhamdulillah, till today this method has not failed us, because it's a short amount of ibadah in a very, very, very compact and comprehensive way. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make it easy for us to do this every single night. Lastly, what I want to address, and I want to really push everybody, is try to make some sadaqah, even if it is £1, £2, £3 a day, or it could even be like 50p a day. The idea is not to give lots of wealth away on the path of Allah. That is not what is required from us, because we can only give as much as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given us. So Allah doesn't test us with the quantity of our charity. He only tests us with the quality of our charity. So as long as we give charity to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to attain the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, even if it is 1 pence, wallahi, and I say wallahi by the name of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that charity will be accepted and will be a fruit for you on the day of judgment. So try to make sadaqah during the day, and try to complete the night in this manner, so that you are able to reap the fruits of Laylatul Qadr. Wallahi, brothers and sisters, please do not waste these nights. These nights are so powerful, so important, that it is such that if a person was to know the value of this night, that they wouldn't even want to wink a little bit. They would just want to worship, worship, worship. But yet me and you are going to be neglectful. We are going to look away. And sometimes it requires us to go and see how our pious predecessors, the Salafus Salihin, how did they used to spend the nights of Laylatul Qadr? You know, it was such a Shaykh Zakariya Khandelwi Rahimahullah. He was such that he never used to even utter a single word except for dhikrullah and the recitation of the Quran in the last 10 days of Ramadan. If we go and look at many, many scholars, this was their way of treating the last 10 days. So why don't we treat the last 10 days like it is the gold that we just found? And remember, if we appreciate it this year, Allah may give us the tawfiq to benefit from it next year. And if we don't appreciate it, we never know. This may be the last time that we find Laylatul Qadr. I prayed to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that He gives us, gives me, gives you, gives every single one of us, every single ummati of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the tawfiq, the capability to make the most out of every single night of Ramadan, and gives us tawfiq to find Laylatul Qadr and be in the presence of angels, rahmah, the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, so that we can be those that are the closest, the muqarribeen, the closest ones to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I pray that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala accepts all our deeds, all our fasts, and He gives us the tawfiq to carry on fasting this month of Ramadan and become obedient servants of His. سمعنا وأطعنا غفرانك ربنا وإليك المصير سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.